Member for Surrey Wally.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. The Minister of Finance has referred repeatedly to the review he ordered last year into Mr. Graydon's embarrassing exit from BC Lottery Corporation. In the news release at the time that the review was released, the Minister said, and I quote, BCLC found no evidence that Michael Graydon or his new employer benefited from the conflict. The Minister repeated that claim here in the House on May the 12th of this year, and indeed he's repeated it moments ago. We now know that that simply wasn't true. Let me read from this letter that BCLC buried for over a year, the one that Mr. Graydon wrote, and the timing is important, while he was negotiating his pay and benefits with the owners of Edgewater Casino, and I quote, first, as it pertains to the decision to increase the betting limits on high limit tables, I have provided my approval for BCLC's casino and gaming division to work with the casino service providers to implement changes to these limits so that they are in place prior to January 31st, 2014, and in particular at the Edgewater and River Rock casinos. Madam Speaker, Mr. Graydon left the BCLC for Paragon, the owner of Edgewater Casinos, 2 days after his self-imposed deadline. Mr. Speaker, can the Minister tell this House why Mr. Graydon didn't, why did the Minister tell this House that Mr. Graydon didn't make decisions to benefit his future employer when clearly he did?
Minister of Finance.
There is, Madam Speaker, a couple of problems with the theory that the member and his colleagues choose to advance, and here is where I believe those difficulties lie. I'm reminded that the consideration around establishing the higher betting limits began in September 2013, long before there was any consideration being given around Mr. Graydon's departure. That's point one. Point two, the decision that was made, if members are interested in the response, I'm happy to give one, Madam Speaker. Secondly, the decision that is of concern to members opposite is one that had positive ramifications for a whole range of agencies, a whole range of service providers, and not just the one that Mr. Graydon ended up having a future employment relationship with. And thirdly, Madam Speaker, the benefits of the decision flowed directly to the BC Lottery Corporation and directly to the taxpayers of British Columbia in the guise of an additional $103 million in revenue that was put to work in healthcare and education. So the fundamental premise upon which the allegation is made, Madam Speaker, simply isn't correct.
Member for Surrey Wally on a supplemental.
Thank you. Well, clearly the minister has advanced a couple of possible defenses. Unfortunately, none of them bear out. Why then did Mr. Graydon mention in particular Edgewater and River Rock, those two casinos, the one of which owned by his employer-to-be at the end of January 2014? Secondly, the idea that benefits flow to the coffers of British Columbia is true, but they also flowed particularly to Paragon, his future employer. So those two proposed defenses the minister advances simply don't hold any water. The review into Mr. Graydon's departure included interviews with Mr. Graydon, personal interviews, key executive and staff across BCLC, and it included a review and analysis of electronic and physical files. Yet nowhere in the report is there even a single mention of this significant policy change that Mr. Graydon personally signed off on in December 2013, a policy that government regulators had serious concerns about. In fact, the review concluded that Mr. Graydon did nothing to benefit his future employer during his last 2 months on the job. This long-buried letter demonstrates that that conclusion is demonstrably false. Mr. Speaker, can the Madam Speaker, can the minister tell the House why he signed off on a report that omitted key facts about Mr. Graydon's actions in support of his future employer, Paragon?
Minister of Finance.
I think, Honourable Speaker, the member's question was, why did I sign off on a report? I can assure the member that when I ask for an independent review, the last thing I want to do is sign off on it. It's an independent review because it's intended to examine the circumstances that occurred and to provide a report on that, Madam Speaker. So the member and his colleagues clearly have a different idea of what is independent than I do, but that's for them to decide. There are decisions that are made by the CEO of organizations that are of general application. This was one of them. This was one of those decisions. And insofar as the authors of the review came to their conclusions, it was on the basis, Madam Speaker, of a thorough examination of all of the circumstances and all of the activities undertaken by the former CEO prior to his departure. I will say again, as I have said in the past, that I was not satisfied with the manner in which Mr. Graydon transitioned from his role at BC Lottery Corporation to other activities. Not satisfied at all. Madam Speaker, I am satisfied that the review that was undertaken was thorough, was comprehensive, and was complete.